Welcome back to Let's Play Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, Legend of Heroes Blind. We're here at the Tirasweel, which is another name for open sea. Well, it's a ship. And we're heading for Negar, N-E-G-A-R Island. I'm waiting for something to happen. Should we look here again? Best place on a boat, okay. Try to steer it, no. Oh, what's this? Chris says, yeah, what's that? I don't know what it is, but it's so big. Oh, they see something in the water. Is that giant creature they were talking about? What happened? Tobias says. I love this song. Tobias, do you know what that is? Yumio stammers. It can't be. No. It's impossible. Something that looks like a giant gnarl was moving south towards the coast of Negar Island. What is a gnarl? Chris says, it looks as if a mountain was moving through the water. I'm positive, Tobias says. That's Galga. Yeah, the one they were talking about. What? Galga? Chris says. Galga? A duo of young pilgrims, Yurio and Christina, set off from Ragpick Village. What they see in the magic mirror at the Shrine of the Water in Dean is unexpected and worrying. Yet the kindness of the people they meet on their journey relieves those worries, little by little. Just then, Yurio and Christina encounter the sea monster Galga while crossing to Negar Island to visit the second shrine. Prologue, Pilgrims, End! Well, you finally made it past the prologue. Wonder how long... Chapter 1, Gems in Tegura. I wonder how long the other chapters will be. If they're going to be longer or about the same. Or maybe shorter. That wouldn't make sense, though. Yurio says, it's real. It's Galga. Tobias says, maybe Negar Island... Tegura was attacked by Galga. Chris says, I thought Galga doesn't attack people. Yes, I read the same in a book, I think it was. Where is it going? Yurio asks. To the direction of Nelva, the capital of Menarth. That's bad news. If that monster comes attacking, the man-made castle will be gone in a flash. I wonder if Galga will land. Hey, Chris, Tobai, look! We're actually going to see this thing? What? Chris says. Oh. Who the hell is this? Someone is on the boat. Yurio says, let's call out. Hey! 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 Oh, he's gone. He's gone. Chris says, the man on the small boat wore such a serious face. He's probably a villager of Tegura, Tobias says, which Galga demolished. After such a tragic experience, your face would naturally become serious. That's right, Chris says. Tobias says, by the way, we're closing in on Negar Island. Prepare to disembark. Okay. Soon the Tirasweel, carrying Yurio and Chris, safely arrived at the docks on Negar Island. They were worried about the damage left by Galga, but at least the docks were unscathed. The Shrine of Tegura is close. They could only hope the shrine was spared by Galga's attack. Yurio and Chris left the Tirasweel nervously. Indeed. Chris says, thank you, Tobai. Don't mention it. Yurio also says thank you, Tobai. Tobai says, how are you going to go back from the island? I thought I was going to leave you here, but now with Galga's attack, I don't think you can find a boat back. That's true, Chris says. What should we do? Since I've brought you here, I'll wait for you. You won't need more than 2 days to finish what you must do, right? Yes, Yurio says. We just have to visit the Shrine of Tegura, so 2 days will be enough. Okay then. You should go now. Be careful. Okay, Tobai. Thanks, Chris says. Thank you, Tobai, Yurio says again. Do you have anything else to say? Thank me later. Go ahead and finish your errand. Okay. But it's too late. We've thanked you thoroughly already. A man from Tegura is staring at the West Sea. He is talking to himself. His name's Nick. Lodi went out, looking very upset. It's suicide to try and take Galga by himself. He has such a tiny boat. Oh, that must have been the man we saw on the boat. Lodi? What is he going to do all by himself? Lodi? Okay. I'd like to talk to him about that we saw him, but... Hello? What's this place? Biano, the guard says. What a misfortune. Our village was attacked by Galga, just as we're entering a busy season. We must prepare for shipments of peat and jewels. Looks like I must take care of all these packages myself. I can't just sit here Sorry, guys. I can't just sit here and complain. I'll cheer myself up by preparing for shipments. Okay. You do that. Well, it could be a nasty fall. Oh, what's up with you now? Can't be hungry already. Normal mood. Doesn't look hungry. Well, you're... Had the little thing over your head. Wait, you found something? Cure potion? We can't carry anymore. Nagor Island. Pronounce with care. Hello? Yurio, locals are coming this way. Let's ask them if the shrine is safe. That's a good idea. Excuse me, Chris says. Are you from Tegura? Amina says yes. Yurio says, we are pilgrims. Did Galga destroy the shrine too? Well, I just know the village was destroyed. Our house is completely gone. I hear the shrine also sustained severe damage. We can't continue to live on this island anymore. We're leaving to stay with our relatives on the mainland. Oh, okay, and Inta says, Mom, is our boat there yet? They'll come before the sea is covered with drift ice. Let's wait in the warehouse at the port. Chris says, the boat which brought us here is waiting at the port. Shall we ask the owner if he could take you back too? That would be great. Could you do that for us? Please. I think it's a good idea. Why don't you wait in the warehouse until we come back from the shrine? We'll do that. We'll be waiting for you in the warehouse at the port. See you later. Yurio says, wait for us. Inta says, yes, we'll be waiting for you. Bye. Bye. Now we could just continue on to the shrine. You have that symbol again. Now you're in a bad mood. Why? You're not hungry? All I can do is praise you. Like I should. Your pet is showing off somewhat. We could You're still doing that. It's in a bad mood. I don't know why. We can ask him. Oh, they've gathered here. Is this... Amina? Yeah. Could you wait until I finish organizing the packages here? Chris says, that works out well for both of us. We haven't finished our job yet either. We'll come back once we're done, so please wait for us here. Yes, we'll be here. What we haven't asked... So she's helping him with the packages. We haven't asked the guy who runs the boat yet. I was desperate being left alone with all these packages, but fortunately Amina showed up and offered me a hand. It's such a big help. Well, where's the little kid? Oh, there you are. Can I get on the boat at the pier? I can't wait. I should have brought Rimu with me. Who's that? Anything new to say? Nope. Alright, let's see if we ask him this. Oh. Apparently we can't ask him yet. Okay. Whether he'll bring them or not. I guess it's just accepted that he will. Alright, let's continue on to the shrine. Well, let's fight this. It's a monkey or something? A stone ape. Pet's anger. Sweet. Oh, nice! Okay, a scout bird we have too. Let us test thy mettle. Oh, we missed! We don't often miss like that. That deserves a finishing move. Let's see you evade this. Yeah, wow. 199 points. Hi. Poking frenzy? God. Tegura! Oh, what'd you find? Wait. Oh, I messed it up. The wrong button. No, oh, cure potion. I hardly ever use them. Somebody. And another somebody's. Mrs. Sukala says, come to think of it, we haven't had any witches visiting the shrine for quite some time. The witch who came 20 years ago was the last one. I remember it was her who told us we could produce peat in the cave. Fishing used to be the only lifeline of this island, but peat gave us another source of income. The village was destroyed by Galga, but we still have peat. We may not be able to live affluently, but we can get by. This may be a blessing of that witch. Maybe. Mayor Elek says, oh, travelers, I'm Elek, the mayor of Tegura. You've come all the way, but we can't offer you anything. Galga destroyed everything, as you can see. I'm sorry. Chris says, mayor, don't lose your heart too much. The mayor says, when the earth forgets to produce, a mountain will cross the sea, and you will hear the grief-stricken voices of people. The prophecy of the witch came true. The prophecy of the witch, Yurio says? A witch who visited us around 20 years ago left these words on her way back from the shrine. I laughed it away then. The witch probably saw this village being destroyed by Galga in the magic mirror of the shrine. Okay, he says that again. Everything she said came true. Hello. Pale says, Lodi is so unlucky. When he finally had a chance to fight Galga, he was in the mines and missed the monster. He must be feeling terrible. So he's been planning this for a while, apparently. I sympathize with Grandpa Kevin, but I also understand how Lodi feels. Well. Seems like a suicidal mission, if you ask me. Hi. Mole the Chapel Master. Your name is Mole? Welcome. Our house is damaged, but we're still running our business here. Alright, we got food. Or fleeting food. Boost your party's chance to dodge attacks in combat, and vicious food. Boost your party's chances of scoring critical hits during combat. Interesting, but we have enough food for now, I think. Please visit us whenever you need food for your pets. I'll think about it. Jack the Arms Dealer says, welcome. You can't prepare too much. Although nothing can beat Galga, you should at least take a look around. Go ahead and browse our wares. We're bound to have something that meets your fancy. Kajita's wares. Short sword. Ideal for beginner swordsmen. Well, I think this is already what he has. Ruby staff for Chris. Yeah, wooden shield that Yurio has that. Leather armor. Okay, is it defense of 34. Light and comfortable armor made from patches of leather. Moderately protective. And silk robes. Elegant robes made of silk, the sound of which is pure music. Alright, so let's get the leather armor. Yes, I am sure. So, I don't think Chris can wear it. So she has silk robes already. Oh, she can. Okay. So I'm gonna get another leather armor then for Yurio. I don't know why I step away. This seems like a natural thing to do. So his lucky vest. From 30 to 34. So I can sell this stuff. Lucky vest. And the silk robes. Keeping the white stone in case we need it for something. Yeah, okay, we're done. Hello. Coil says, welcome. What can I get you today? We got a Kupo potion. A bitter antidote that immediately cures a poison character. Huh. Let's get two of them. Never know when you're gonna need to be healed by poison. Oh, he's got Saffy Volume 2, the duel. A power ring plus one. Okay, we have to exchange if we're gonna need enough money for that. We're gonna have enough money for that. Boost the wearer's strength, increasing combat effectiveness. And then we get a magic ring plus one. Boost the power of magic spells cast by the wearer. Seems like worthwhile things to have. We can exchange here, right? Don't mind my bunny, he's in a bad mood. Exchange complete. Alright, so we have plenty of money now to be getting this stuff. We'll get a power ring for Yurio, and a magic ring for Chris. Oh, the white stone can be equipped. Oh, I didn't know that. And increase your MDE, which I looked that up. I forget what it does. But yeah, Yurio. attack from 50 up to 55. That should help. So he can also wear this. Okay, MDE. It's gotta be magic something. Magic defense? I'm guessing it's magic defense. Well, Yurio, I mean, Chris has the least amount of things. I mean, as far as points and such. She's the weaker one, so I'll have her wear both. So, it's gotta be magic, yeah, attack. And magic defense. Makes sense. Okay, so up from 32 to 37. And then magic defense from 24 to 29. There we go. And what about this book? Sweet, we have a separate section for books. I like it. Safi, Volume 2, The Duel. The Duel. Safi and Brad's first encounter was on a cold night under a new moon. Safi was hired by Viscount, I think it's pronounced Viscount? Tourmarine, to take part in a duel. The opposing party was Garnet, eldest son of Baron Jade and a popular figure in social circles. Garnet's arrogance had crossed the line once too often, and Viscount Tourmarine was determined to teach him a lesson. Back then, it was common practice to send a proxy to a duel between aristocrats. The Tourmarine family hired Safi, while the Jade family named Brad to represent them. Brad. With their respective patrons looking on, the two swordsmen faced each other, neither needing a cue to begin a duel. The Sioux swordsmen drew their swords, the sharp sound of metal echoing in the dark of night. Okay. Look forward to reading the next one. Oh. This place seen better days. Katero says, it's awful. Terrible. Amina's house is completely gone. This is beyond words. I don't blame them for leaving the island. Oh, I shouldn't have said this. Amina told me not to tell anyone because she hates saying goodbye to the villagers. I don't think she minds telling you because you're travelers. Amina has been raising Inta by herself. She's been through a lot. I hope she will find a good life on the mainland. But I'm sure Rimu, Inta's playmate, will be saddened to hear his best friend has left. Are you Rimu? Yes, you are. I'm Rimu. This used to be my house. Galga broke it into pieces. My mom has been managing the chapel here. Yurio says, so it's the same as Chris's family. So you're also from a chapel family? Chris says, yes, I am. Then you can also use spells, right? Our house is gone, but we have a temporary chapel at the entrance of the village. Drop by if you're interested. By the way, where did Inta go? We promised to play together. We're not telling you. You'll never find out. Jashika says, it was completely ruined. Everything was shattered to pieces. I used to run an inn here, but I won't be able to do business for a while. I don't even have a place to sleep tonight. I'm so mad at Galga. Well, it doesn't make sense if Galga's a peaceful thing. Maybe there's more than one sea creature out there. This place goes way back. There's another house to the south of there. Yeah, let's go check it out. Grandpa Kevin says, Lodi must have left alone in search of Galga. He gives nothing but worries to his grandfather. Going out on such a tiny boat is like throwing his life away. Chris says, Lodi? Is he the guy we passed on the Tirada? The people at the docks are also talking about him. And now we finally have someone to say this to. Yurio says, ah, that guy with a serious face. Kevin says, have you seen Lodi? Yes, Chris says. We came here on a boat from Arud to view the magic mirror as part of our pilgrimage. We passed Lodi's boat at the entrance to the port. Tell us, Grandpa, Why did Lodi chase after Galga? To take his revenge on Galga. Really? Is he going to take down such a fearful monster by himself? When Lodi was small, most people on a Negar island earned their living by fishing. I usually went fishing with my son, but that day Lodi insisted on coming with my son. It was his first time Lodi was on our fishing boat. My son and Lodi left happily, but their boat was attacked by Galga. Galga killed my son. That's horrible, Chris says. Yurio says, I thought that Galga was a tame creature. Normally, but once in a while Galga becomes violent as if it was possessed by something. The devastation of Tegura was caused by another violent episode of Galga. Miraculously, Lodi was spared and washed up on the island 3 days later. He's wanted to avenge his father's death since then. As soon as he was able to use swords, he left me, his grandfather, in Tegura to complete his mission of revenge. Chris says, Lodi has been chasing Galga all his life. Yeah, no kidding, he's been planning this for a while. He came back out of the blue, but then Galga appeared. I don't understand. Talk to him, right? Oh, I left. I didn't want to leave. No leavings. So, it opens up and goes back further that way. I just don't want to miss anything. This is where the mayor is. I guess that's the mayor's wife. It's so funny because it's mayor something and it's always misses something else. Oh, wait, what? Stimulant, thank you. How many do we have now? 9, wow. Hopefully you find some Koopo potions for us soon. Those are pricey. Yeah, what is it? I'm walking this way. I always seem to like stop at a halt over there, even though I'm not choosing to. Alright, so I wonder if there's something else back here. I think I talked to you. Yeah. Nope. You're finding a lot of stuff. Stimulant, yay! Now we're full of stimulant. Can't carry anymore. Well, finding a lot of crap. Yeah, I'm not sure what else to do here. I don't think there's anything else we can do here. We might as well proceed on to the shrine, I guess. Oh. Sorry, I accidentally just walked straight into your house. I want to leave. Oh, it's to the... Right, it's to the west. I'm used to the entrances being, you know, down to the south. So wait, how do I... Do we just walk right through? How do I get to the shrine? I think there's a fence on that side, though. Hmm. What is your issue? Your pet's stomach is rumbling from hunger. Okay. You have some stamina food, then. It gulps down the stamina food. You like that better than the seafood, I think. Wait, wait, now you found something. A recure potion. That's new. You found something else as well? Damn. A recure potion containing a recure spell. Heals a large amount of damage. Well, we'll save that up. And what else did you find? Getting spoiled over here. Oh, no cure potion. Okay. Does this lead to the shrine? Hello there. Ben the Miner says, "You must be pilgrims. My name is Ben. I'm a peat miner. We're taking turns to stand here to make sure travelers like you don't get lost. Keep going north and you'll get to the peat mines. Continue to east and you'll see the Shrine of Tegura. Now you know your way." Thank you, Uncle Ben, Chris says. You're welcome. It looks like the magic mirror in the shrine survived Galga's attack, so don't worry. Keep going... Yeah, he said that. You take care. Alright, let's head for the shrine then first. I'm sure we'll go to the mines eventually. Oh, gonna fight monkey things. Stamina! Defense up. Sweet. Let's take out the stone ape. You missed. Wow, 291 points. Missed again. Oh, we found fleeting food. Helps us move quicker or something. Those are missing a lot. Rock shot? Ow! Stinker? Poking frenzy. Oh my god, he's got one hit point? I did not notice him being so... weak. Uh-oh. Oh! It's not my first time seeing the game over screen. I should have just revived him. Yeah, I'm gonna have to, Yeah, I'll see you guys in a little bit, because I gotta... I guess do all this stuff over again. Cure potion. Okay, we did everything over the same way I played through the whole part over. It's a lot faster when you don't have to voice the dialogue, though. So, the only thing is, we did not find, or our rabbit did not find a recure potion for us last time. And I think the stimulants we managed to fill up, now we have 9. I still bought the Kupo potion, 2 of them like last time. I bought the book again. And, I got them the same armor, the leather, and the power ring. and the magic ring and the white stone we put on. Tegura Shrine. Well. Hafka says, Galga's sudden attack must have been quite a shock to the sage. He retreated to his room and hasn't come out since. I like Sage's sermon more than anything. I hope he'll come out soon. Paste? Past? You must be! Are you pilgrims too? Yes, Chris says. We came from Ragpick Village. That's good. Have you seen the magic mirror yet? No, I haven't seen it yet, Yurio says. You must be pretty excited. Please come back and tell us what you saw after you view the mirror. Will do. Got a book here. There's a book that reads The Secret Treasures of Pirate King Ramon on the spine. Yurio takes the book in his hands and opens it. The Secret Treasures of Pirate King Ramon. After stealing and looting across the seven seas, the Pirate King Ramon and his fleet were finally defeated by the courageous Captain Thomas and sank into the Emerald Sea. However, all the treasures stolen by Ramon were never found. The cautious Ramon hid the treasures he collected from various ships and never left a clue. His treasures were reportedly valued at hundreds of millions of piers and are still waiting to be found. They attract many treasure hunters. How interesting, Yurio says. Alright, we came in here, I think, right? No, we came in here. That must be the way to the magic mirror, then. So I'm going to call in an episode here. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and see you next time when we finally visit the shrine, the mirror, the magic mirror, at Tegura. Thanks so much for watching, and always, seek adventure.